Welcome to today's social studies class of grade 4, lesson 4, Life in the Desert. Yes, now what is a desert? A desert is a flat area which is covered with loose sand. And where do we have desert in our country? Yes, the Thar Desert. You can see it in the map. Yes, India has a large desert to the west of the Aravalli Hills. Almost the entire Rajasthan, the state Rajasthan, comes under the desert. The Rajasthan desert, it lies in the south of Punjab and Haryana. It is called as the Great Indian Desert or also known as Thar Desert. Yes? The Aravalli Hills over the east, it has the Aravalli Hills that cover in the east part. And it has land of rocks, dunes and barren land. Barren land means you cannot cultivate anything here. Like wheat, maize, rice, you cannot cultivate. Yes, the soil here does not allow you to cultivate, even the climate. Let us discuss about it more. Sand dunes are the low hills of the sand formed by the wind. So sand dunes, you know, as the wind blows, a sand dune is formed. Then again the wind blows, so the sand slowly moves and again. So it is really confusing. It is not like fixed. Every time, like if you see every, like the moment wind blows, the sand dunes might have changed their position. Yes, so this was about sand dunes. Now coming to the rainfall here is very scanty. That is no normal rainfall. Yes, like we have rainy season full of rain, we play, right? But here no, there is no, scanty means very, very low rainfall. And so there is hardly any vegetation. Vegetation in the sense, plants, forests, trees, no, because of the low rainfall. And Indira Gandhi Canal is a boon to the people in Rajasthan. So you can see the picture there. It is the Indira Gandhi Canal. So the people, they treat this well, like, you know, they worship this canal because this is the water source. Water is very important now because they know the value. How precious water is, the people here know. Yes. So apart from this, there are tube wells which are used for irrigation. Yes. So these are the sources of water which the people here use. Now wheat, cotton, fruits, jowar and bajra, gram, rye, maize, etc. They are grown here. With the available little water resources near them, they grow these little crops. Most of the people here are nomads. Nomads means what? They keep moving. They don't have one fixed place. Okay, this is my house, I will live here for many years. No. They keep moving from one place to another. Yes, they go in, you know, they go in search of pastures for their animals. They have their animals, right? They need to feed them with the pastures, with the grain. They need to graze the animals. Yes, that's why they keep moving from one place to another. So here the people are what? Nomadic in nature. And normally people here move in caravans. Traveling in hot deserts is very difficult, children. Like we see vehicles traveling here, cars and cabs and bikes. Like this, normally they cannot travel here in a desert. And hence camel is the only means. The animal, camel is the only means of transport here. And that's why it takes, you know, it is called as a ship of the desert, as you all know. Yes? So people here, it is their very dearest animal here, camel. Okay? Now there are Banjaras, Bhils, etc. They are the some of the tribes that are, they live in Rajasthan desert. And some of them are blacksmiths and they wear colorful clothes here. You might have seen in movies, right? Or even in some tourism channels where they travel all around the nation. So they wear very colorful clothes. So the women folk wear a lehenga, blouse and a chunni, or also called as odhni. Yes. And the men wear dhoti, kurta and a turban on top. These people here, they love to sing and dance. Beautiful folk songs they sing. Yes. If you get to travel once, please, you know, go cherish this culture. Okay. Though they love to, their main language is Hindi. And the main festivals that are celebrated here are Dashara, Diwali, Holi, Eid, Pushkar, you know, they are the different festivals they celebrate here. The women folk, they celebrate Gaungar, that is the harvest festival of Rajasthan, and Tej. Tej is a, it indicates the monsoon festival. Now they also perform the famous Ghumar dance. I think you all have seen this, right? So in this song also in Hindi, so beautifully they portrayed the Ghumar dance, and they also pray for their husbands for their long life and well-being. All the women here, they pray for the long lives of their husbands. So camel races, puppet shows, folk musics are common here in Rajasthan. Also there in Ajmer, which is present in Rajasthan, there is a very famous Dargah. Okay, and there is a big Urus Mela which is held every year at the tomb of the great saint Khwaja Sahib. So many people come from, you know, from the devotion in their hearts, they visit this Dargah. And jewelry is an integral part of Rajasthan culture. So huge jewelry they wear, and you know, they dress up. Yes. And now coming to the different occupations which people do here, wood carvings, block printing, embroidery, carpet weaving, they are the main occupations of the people living in Rajasthan, or we can also call them Rajasthanis. Yes. So there are mines of copper, zinc as well as mica also present in this region. Okay. Now in the south there are fairy tale palaces like the spectacular Jain temples. Huge, nice, big structures they are. Yes. Important places like Bikaner, Ajmer, Jaipur, Udaipur are some of the cities in Rajasthan. Can you tell me what is the capital of Rajasthan? Yes, Jaipur is the capital of Rajasthan, and it is famous for magnificent palaces, colorful festivals and bazaars. So it is amazing, you know, many people here, they come and have their destination weddings in those palaces. You know, they are so beautiful, they give that royal feel when we go there. You can also see the picture wherein people, how Rajasthanis look like. Yes, they always are dressed up beautifully. So children, this was the lesson on, you know, the life in deserts. I want you to read the lesson once again and complete the exercises given after the lesson. Thank you.